Pulse family, what's good? We got another one coming at you, and this is courtesy of the Pulse fam out there from Johannesburg, Africa. He's like, hey, yo, Thesis, man, yo, I need you to show me Serato Sample, but I need you to really, really dig in. And I said, well, you know what? Let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to do as much as I can anyway, a complete thorough walkthrough of Serato Sample, what you could do with it, the many ways you can utilize it, and trust me, there are a lot of things you could do with this thing, all right? So you guys keep it locked. Stay tuned. Okay, so let's start with a total clean slate of Serato Sample. Now, there are a lot of people who use Serato Sample in different ways. I have a machine micro, right? So to slice is a little difficult as opposed to having the machine plus, which you can do all your cuts, your slices right there, which is super dope. To me, this is why Serato Sample, you know, has to be one of the best sampler VSTs out there. So let's first go over what is in the actual description, the features, things like that. And then we're going to dive directly in as to what each feature will do. First, let's start off with the actual GUI. So as you see, when you bring it up, it comes up with this and it talks about loading an audio file. So I've already downloaded an audio file. We're going to use a good old gospel sample. All right. So of course, that's the best way to chop. So the way that you go and get samples, right? The legal way of doing it, TrackLib is one place where you can go and get great samples. You can also go to Splice and get some awesome soul samples or whatever type of sample or genre that you want to dig into. Those are great places in which I would advise. I know that there are people out there that will still use YouTube to download. So I'm not going to advise where to go, but you know, that's the case. But anywho, let's go over all the features of Serato Sample. So on the beginning, you have a play button feature. Now, the way that it works is you can play it on the keyboard. You can play it with your MIDI transposer. Like say, if you got a machine or a Kai, you can use those pads to actually play with the actual samples as well. But in this case, I'm gonna go ahead and utilize the keyboard. But once you play it, that's the actual play function for it. Beside that, you have what we call a continuous and a stop. So basically, when you want to continue to just play the sample, let me move this over. So when you want to continue the sample and you want it to play all the way through, once you hit a key, it'll continue to keep playing. See? So to continue to keep playing like that. If you want it to not do that, but you want to play and then stop every time you hit a key, that's what that feature is. Beside that, you have mono and poly. And of course, we'll get into more of the functionality of that once we get into more of the actual lesson. Beside this, you have the name of the sample that you picked, the key and the BPM that is detected from that actual sample. Beside that, you can go and change your actual key. So say for instance, if I wanted to change the key, I could do this and it would change the actual sound of the actual key. It'll go up to, in this case, a D minor, which is +2. Beside that, you have the sync option. And of course, once you load this up and load the sample, it automatically syncs to whatever DAW that you're using. The actual sample is detected originally as 84. So let's say for instance, if I wanted to change it to, let's just hypothetically do 120. As you see right here, it'll change it to 120. If you unlock the sync, then it will automatically go to what Serato Sample is detecting is the actual BPM. Beside that, you have the double speed. You have the actual way you can half time it. So that's what the X, Y up top here is. And the 1, 2 right there is the half time. It'll slow it down. You have the parameters, which of course you have a level, a filter, attack, release. Beside that, you have the reverse. Which you actually, in this case, let's say for instance, if I move this down and then you hit reverse, then it'll go backwards. That's a real cool feature. The key shift. Now, this is a little different from the actual key on top of Serato. So the key up top will change the entire sample, right? If you see all these nodules down here, the actual pads, this right here is where that I can go in and actually change the actual keys and then I can shift the key as opposed to changing the entire samples. The chop itself would change as opposed to entire sample. Beside that, you can time stretch it. So say for instance, if you're finding a place where you're coming a little bit off once you're playing the actual key and you want to just stretch it a little bit, this is a perfect place to do that. You can make a favorite of any sample that you have. Say for instance, you pick a favorite there, and then it'll put a star right there to show, okay, this is a sample that I want to keep. And below that, you have where you can key shift pads, you can select randoms, you can set a slicer, you can find samples. And beside this is where you can get into a keyboard mode. Keyboard mode is basically when you are playing the keys and you want to play it across in a different key. And of course, right here, this is where you can select all of your samples. And of course, this is just the delete function. Up here where you see the arrows, right? These are history. So you have a redo and an undo. You also have a zoom in function right here where you can go in and get as close as you possibly can to the beginning of whatever sample that, whatever placement actually that you want to start that chop in. And of course you can zoom it back out. And this is where you can actually freeze the sample. What first thing I want to do is I want to show how to utilize the actual feature of finding the actual sample. Now, once you go down here, you can pick where you can find samples and then you can hit that and it'll automatically find samples for you. Let's get rid of that. You can also go and set slicers. Now, the slicers are basically set off of bars. In this case, I want to do, let's say, 2, set a slicer. So now back at the beginning, once you set your tone to 2, it'll set it to 2 bars. You can go as high as you want, 16, but we're going to set it for 2, and then it's going to go every 2 bars. And like I said, if you have an actual MIDI controller with pads, you can do the same thing. I think a lot of people like to use the, you know, the pad version as opposed to the actual keyboard version. So whatever floats your boat, right? For setting randoms, right? You can just set a random and it'll just find whatever sample placement, you know, based off just being random. It's still going to be 16 pads regardless, but it's going to pick 16 random slices. You know, you can take a chance and have fun with that. But for me, in this case, we're going to go and just set a slicer for 2. Of course, I always like to zoom in. That's just my thing. All right. So because I like the beginning part, we're going to set a slicer for that. Now, for the sake of the video, you know, I'm not going to be focusing on trying to make a beat. I'm going to be just focusing on the actual functionalities of doing different things. So in this case, let's zoom in, and this is the first sample of this sound. And remember I said the keyboard function. So now let's just play around and show you guys what the keyboard function does. So now I've hit the keyboard function. So what it does now is that I should be able to play the same key, right, of that sound, but now it's just going to be like I'm playing the piano. See what I mean? So that's pretty dope. That's what the keyboard function does. Let's say for instance, if you want to change the filter of a sound. All right. One thing is that I think I want to set it to 4. All right. So we'll get back to that. So now it's at 4. So it's at 4 bars. All right, let's stick with that. Now this is where you get, you know, creative, and let's say you want to halftime it. You just hit halftime. You can do that, or you can speed it up by double time. Then here's another way of getting creative. So say for instance, if you want to change the filters on it, you could change it like that. And make sure that you also change the filter on that next key that you hit. But you turn it down, let's see, this one was at 192. So this one, 192, just to keep it the same. Or we do 188. course, that's going to change your actual sync. So now let's sync it back up. Now it's back in the halftime. Right? When you time stretch, just be real careful with that. It still does a great job in, you know, making sure that it keeps the BPM, but you know, you just got to know how to actual time stretch. So again, it always does. It does a great job already of doing that without doing it. So it all depends on your song, how you're sampling, things like that. I want to show you guys now how to use one shots, right? So let's get rid of that sample. I'm going to go through my sounds real quick. Let's just open up a random sound. All right. So I'm opening up a hi-hat. Okay. All right, so now we are zoomed in as much as we possibly can, right? So now we're focusing on one shots, and this is a crazy way of making different tones inside of one shot. So a hi-hat is a great way of playing around with. So now we're just gonna make four. So we have the same one, right? Now this is where it gets really, really cool. You can go change this key, and then you can actually go and reverse it. So remember, now we got to go here. And you can do that. A lot of people like to go filter their sounds. So this is another way of doing it too. So now you can actually make your own hi-hat. That is a great way, I think, of, you know, doing something where you can make your own hi-hats, your own sounds. And don't forget, you can do this with any one shot. So be creative, have fun. Knock yourselves out. So hopefully this video definitely helped you guys out, and it gave a little bit more understanding, a little bit more meaning. If you guys like this video, please make sure that you definitely do a thumbs up to this, and that you guys drop down to the comments in the sections. If I miss anything, please let me know, and then we'll do an update video to it, or whatever the case we need to be, we'll do it to make sure that you guys get the info. Definitely appreciate you guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Please sub. Everybody has been supporting us. It's a brand new year, so like I said, we got a lot of different things that we want to bring to the table to make sure that you guys get to the best of your ability in the production and what you have, all right? So once again, you guys already know who it is. It is your boy Thesis. Peace.